Hi, Namaste. Welcome to today's session. So in the previous session, we were discussing about the topic. How did the different group of people saw the movement? The movement is civil disobedience movement. So to the concept, we discussed about two different classes of people. First one, rich peasants. Second one, poor peasants. Then moving ahead, let us discuss how did people saw the movement. Today's discussion will be about business class people. So during First World War, Indian merchants and industrialists, they made large profit or huge profit, and they became more powerful. So in expanding their business, now they reacted with the political leaders and also with the civil disobedience movement, and reacting against colonial policies which restricted the business activities of these group of people. They reacted because they wanted protection against imports of foreign goods and rupee sterling foreign exchange ratio that would discourage imports. They supported the civil disobedience movement when it was first launched. They gave all kind of financial assistance and they refused to buy and sell imported goods in their business. They were oppressive of the spread of militant activities or military activities, and even they were worried about prolonged disruption of business as well as the growing influence of socialism among younger members of Congress. Then industrial working class people. The industrial working class people, they not took active part and active participation in the civil disobedience movement in large number, but the industrial working people from Nagpur, they took their part in this civil disobedience movement. As the industrialist came very closer to the Congress, workers stayed far from the civil disobedience movement. In spite of this, some workers did not participate in civil disobedience movement. Selectively, some workers with adopting some of the ideals of Gandhian programs like boycotting of foreign goods as a part of their own movement, and they took part in this movement, and their main demand is against low wages and poor working condition.
Then, woman also took her part and participation in civil disobedience movement. It became very important feature for the movement as the large number of woman participants took part in the movement. So during Dandi March, thousands of women came out of their home to listen to the ideals and principles of Gandhiji. They motivated, they inspired, they participated in the protest march, manufactured salt, picketed foreign cloth and liquor shops. Many women went to jail, and in urban areas women were from high caste families, and in rural areas they came from rich peasant households. So with this, let me stop today's session and let us continue the last part of the chapter in tomorrow's session. Thank you. Thank you, Ananda.